Hey, fish folks, and welcome to another episode of Streets Tanks. Today, I have some helpers in the house. I have my beautiful girlfriend, Zoe, and her mother, Madison, is here. Say hi to Madison. That's Madison. And over here is my beautiful girlfriend, Zoe. Hey, Zoe. Zoe's taking a little nap over here on the couch. But for my Valentine's Day gift, they got me a brand new saltwater tank. I'm going to set this up and do a step-by-step of how to set up a saltwater tank. So, stay tuned and we will have more on that. So what I have going on so far is we have added the live sand to the aquarium. This is a BioCube 28-gallon. Standard for the most part. I have a protein skimmer on the back of it. It's a little one. We'll see how it does. But this is the live sand. We have some live rock down here in some salt water that I already have prepared. Here's another bucket of salt water, and this is just a clarity package that comes with the salt live rock. And then I have some more dry rock over here. So basically, just throw in your sand. You get your water to the right salinity, and you put your live rock in there. I will show you here a video of the aquascaping and let you show you how we come up with the design of the tank itself. So what I'm doing now is I'm filling the tank up. I have the sand in there, and I'm just using one of the pumps for the return to pump it from this bucket up into here. Now, I do have it going onto a grocery bag. The reason why I do that is just kind of, it rises up as little sediment as possible. I mean, this sand is just filled with small sediment, which is fantastic, but it clouds the water pretty bad. So I'm trying to minimize that by having it go onto the bag. I just thought I'd show that real quick trick. So we're going to fill this up, turn on the filter, see if we can't get this to clear up a little bit before we start putting live rock in. We have the live rock in there now. It's really milky because you know, we were messing around with it, but I think that once it clears up, this should look really cool. But, yeah, not too bad. Obviously, there's a long ways to go, but we have to let the tank cycle and let it go through the ammonia process, and we will slowly be adding fish and corals to that tank, and I will definitely be keeping you updated on that tank. Now, I went last weekend to an event in southern Michigan called the 2017 Mid-Michigan Frag Swap, and I took some videos there. Take a peek. Hi, fish folks, and today we are going to the annual Mid-Michigan Coral Swap. But I gotta hurry up because it's a limited supply, so we gotta really hurry. In all seriousness, no, they are super busy, so probably not gonna be able to talk too much in there, but we'll give you a look and show you how it is. Thank you. if you like salt water, you have to go check it out. There's so much to see and you'll learn so much. I hope you like the video and check in next week for another.